In this screencast, I'm going to describe two interactive simulations, and the links to these simulations are given here. They're located on the Wolfram Demonstration Project site. These are ternary phase diagrams of three components in equilibrium. In this case, what we're looking at are systems where there are regions of partial miscibility. So we get phase separation. We have two phases. Each phase contains all three components. We have two phases in equilibrium with each other over a certain region of the phase space. Now there's another screencast and another interactive simulation for just basic ternary phase diagrams. I won't go into details describing the ternary phase diagram, but let me give you a little idea. I'm showing a snapshot of these two simulations. And then the pure components are on the corners. So for example, this corner corresponds to the pure component B. And then the side, which is the same color, in this case, the side along here, indicates what's the mass fraction of that particular component. And you determine that mass fraction by drawing a parallel line to the base opposite the corner. So you can see this parallel line here indicating this point, a mass fraction of about 0.15 for that component. Likewise for the other axes. And then in this two-phase region, which is shown by an orange line and a purple line, a point in the two-phase region, for example, a point here, corresponds to this phase with this composition and this phase with that composition in equilibrium with each other. So here I'm showing tie lines connecting phases in equilibrium. And of course, phases in equilibrium means the fugacities of each of the components are equal. And then there's a point where the color changes. This is the plat point. On the left is one phase that's in equilibrium on the right side with a phase of different composition. So this is a two-phase region. The region outside is one phase. On the right, the phase separation is different, and this entire region, so here is one of the tie lines connecting this phase in equilibrium with this phase. And so this entire region here is a two-phase region. We get phase separation. In the simulations, you can select various choices as to what are shown on the right. You can see grid lines, you can see tie lines, and then compositions of one of the phases. We look at the simulation, but a little easier to see what's involved. So let's go to one of the interactive simulations. So here's one of the interactive simulations, and I can select this option to better illustrate where we have one phase and where we have two phases on the diagram. And then I can select what I want to display. So I can remove the tie lines to make it less cluttered. I've moved the point around, so I can move the point so it's in the two-phase region, in the one-phase region, with the lines now representing what the compositions are. So I can show grid lines to better illustrate the structure. In this case, I can't select these phases because we're in the one phase region. In the one phase region, you can see the composition is given. Now, if I move the point into the two phase region, it shows just the tie line. I could show all the tie lines, but let's just look at one. Now I can select to show the composition of one phase called the beta phase, the purple. Can also select to show the composition of the other, or I can remove this just so I can more easily visualize how we get these compositions, and then moving around to give us a better idea of what phases are in equilibrium. And then likewise on the other ternary phase diagram, the same idea as we can use our mouse to select what's the composition we want to look at, and a given point in the diagram, the composition is displayed. So hopefully using these interactive simulations will allow you to better understand the behavior. We have a three-component system where there's partial miscibility, so we have phase separation.